Very good morning, students. We are in the third unit of our English lesson, and the unit is labeled Human Relations. As a part of this, we have a wonderful pic over here for comprehension, and followed by a small poem. Please look into the text. So, try to comprehend what it is there in the picture. There you find an old man sitting isolated, and probably is not for solace. He is in gloomy mood, and all around him the routine things are going on: people working, children playing, and many chores, daily chores are going on. So what we are expected to comprehend out of this picture, that is very important. And the few lines given at the bottom, that automatically suggest us what can be grasped over here. So let us read. In the picture, we see an old man where he is not looked after or even recognized his presence by rest of the people who are engaged in their daily course. And probably it is the inherent mind of the old man that is mentioned here in lines. As I sit here alone and waiting, I gaze at people passing me by. I try to smile and reach out to them, but no one notices, no one waits. They look to me like I am nothing. Are they afraid to be seen saying hi to an old man like me? So I read again. As I sit here alone and waiting, I gaze at people passing me by. This is what usually happens in cities where old grandparents are brought to newer residences like apartments. Those people would like to have some rapport with people and would like to have some chit chat. And ultimately what they need, a small thing, should be some fellow who is supposed to talk to them, at least asking for their well-being and wishing some good morning. But here, like our grandparents at home, this old man was sitting and gazing at people, probably they wish him, probably they talk to him. I try to smile and reach out to them, but no one notices, no one waits. All are busy. This is what happening in the present day, towns and cities, the busy life. According to this, people are rushing to their work and people are running behind their jobs for little earning, and they couldn't find any of the companionship of other people, and that too with the spread of this corona, and people have almost become inhumane and were not in a position to even smile at others. Everything is very suspicious. The situation is like that. They look to me like I am nothing. They look to me like I am nothing. One important thing to recollect. In the old 10th class, there was a lesson, Mother Teresa. And one of the interviewers asked Mother Teresa, what might be the worst disease in the world according to her? And Teresa says, you know, Teresa is very much concerned about the sick people, orphan people, and leprosy people like this. People expect that probably she might tell one of the reasons like this. But what she expressed the worst disease in the world is being unwanted. Being unwanted. when somebody doesn't recognize your presence, that is the worst situation for anybody. So here this old man feeling that loneliness. They look to me like I'm nothing. Are they afraid to see, say? Are they afraid to see, to be seen, saying hi to an old man like me? That's what children, if they have grandparents at home, nothing more you need to give them. Just spend little time with them. They feel very much satisfied. Okay? So this is the agony of. And even today we do observe and watch and listen on TV. Due to corona, many of the dead bodies are being unattended by the family members. So the situations are prevailing like this. Even before this corona, people used to be like this because of the busy daily course they need to attend. Yeah. So basing on this picture, we have a comprehension. What is the except about? How do you feel about it? Of course, I have given my version. You can imagine what might be something more. How do people respond to the old man's smile according to the context? Do they respond? No. How should old people be treated so that they do not feel neglected? That's what. It is the very reason having no one to have some rapport with these people. They are getting isolated. They feel very much comfortable in villages, because in villages people use it to talk to each other. But in towns and cities, automatically there is no such environment, and this is the greatest agony of the aged generation present today. Okay. Now coming to reading A. So I expect all of you answering these three questions based on the picture comprehension and make it answer in your classwork. And moving ahead, reading A, the journey. So the total unit deals with human relations, and this wonderful excerpt is written by one of the Northeast writers of India, H. Dorji Thongzi, who was born in 1952, is a prominent name in Assamese literature. You know, Northeast is very much underdeveloped. You have all the 8 states over there, and it's a hilly terrain. Almost the total 8 states are hilly terrain, and education is very meager, and so literature is also scanty. But here and there are people who could bring some literacy out of these downtrodden people. So this concerned Thongzi belonged to Assam. Though he grew up in poverty, he studied well and entered Arunachal Pradesh Civil Service and was later elevated to the Indian Administrative Service, IAS. He writes fiction, drama and essays in Assamese and English. You know, English is the foremost media where you can reach the rest of the world. He has received a national recognition with his novel Mona Arth Mukher Hriday, which won the Sahitya Academy Award in 2005, which is awarded by the Central Government of India. Many of Thongzi's novels, including Sonam, deal with the cultural life of the Mompa and Sherdungpen tribes of Arunachal Pradesh. Yeah, anyhow, nowadays you have been very much familiar with the internet and all. Once you please go through the YouTube and try to watch what is the way of living conditions of Ladakh and other localities of Himalayan foot, you come to know how horrible the life condition of these people. Okay, so this extract is story is written in the form of a biography. We have already discussed as a part of major discourses, biography is a kind of writing written by the writer himself or herself. Okay? Yes. So, Tongzi expresses his life experiences, as we have already come across. This is one of the toughest time for him to get educated and also elevate into the level of a civil servant in Arunachal Pradesh government. Let us see. The story starts. After spending a leisurely Sunday at home, the very thought of returning to work on Monday is tiring. Lethargy creeps in if the holiday continues over an extended period. That is how I felt when I was preparing to return to my place of work after spending 6 months at home. The fact that I was to leave behind my newly wed wife and go to a far off place did not help either. Obviously, I did not want to go. So this is a biography. It is time to tell us what is an experience he had in his life. So the author, he had put leave for 6 months to get married and came home. And his leave completed, and that was the day he had to start back to his work. But it's a human psychology. Lethargy, in a sense, laziness. If it is a Sunday, Monday morning definitely we come late to school. It's a human psychology because we try to take all the opportunities to skip work. So it's the same thing that happened with Tongzi. After spending a leisurely Sunday at home, the very thought of returning to work on Monday is tiring. So this is the commonest thing. And unfortunately now we have March, April, May, June, July, August, 6 months of holidays from school. Imagine, as per the schedule given by the government, if school starts in September, even our situation might be like this. Lethargy creeps in if the holiday continues over an extended period. Lethargy. It's a kind of laziness. That is how I felt when I was preparing to return to my place of work after spending 6 months at home. Just like how we got 6 months holidays due to Corona, he voluntarily put leave for his marriage and now about to start for work. The fact that I was to leave behind my newly wed wife and go to far off place did not help either. Obviously, I did not want to go. So this is his condition. He got married and he had to leave the wife at home and go for work. Obviously, anyone doesn't like it. Second paragraph. However, I finally did decide to go. So when lethargy dominates, will be almost behind the screen. Because so long we are active, automatically we proceed in the life. If laziness dominates, automatically we will be in the back bench of our lives. So finally decided to go. I did not have much to carry by way of luggage, just a trunk. Ours is a hilly terrain without any motorable roads, and there is no certainty that we are ever going to have any roads. In any case, while coming home, we do not carry bedding. Besides, I had come home this time drawn for a special purpose, to get married. My parents had arranged my marriage according to the customs of our tribal society. Time flew, and 5 months into my marriage, I realized it. Initially, I thought of extending my leave, even taking unpaid leave, but after some dilly-dallying, I finally decided against it because marriage had increased my responsibilities and I had got into debt. So, as per the story he expressed, the very purpose he is live is to get married. So, it was a custom in a tribal system, still it is an arranged system is going on for marriages, and he got arranged a marriage with a bride, and his parents called upon him, and he could live for 6 months. So, as it is a situation, he left all his luggage at his workplace, not carried everything what he had. So, what he had right now with him to carry back to the workplace is only a trunk. Trunk in the sense, it's like a suitcase, but big in size. You know, in olden days, we don't have any of the suitcase and briefcase American tourister like that. We have a trunk made of iron sheet, and it can be carried on the back. And usually, even today, we can observe railway guards, railway drivers, and military people carrying their trunks. This is the age-old fashion in India. So, he had nothing to carry back except the trunk. On my way home from the bus stop, my trunk had been carried by a porter. The problem now was, we couldn't find anyone who could help me carry the trunk to the bus stop. Why? Because since the bus stop, he had to walk a long way in the terrain to reach his home. So, there are no motorable roads. No bike can be ridden and no four-wheeler can be. So, the only possible means of transportation is only by foot. So, from bus stop to home earlier, a porter carried his trunk. So, he had reached so convenient his home. Now, taking trunk from home to bus stop, it is about some kilometers up and down the hill. So, no porter is available in the village. So, he had to carry it. But an educated person carrying a trunk, you know, we have some false prestige. All this came into his mind. The problem now was, we couldn't find anyone who could help me carry the trunk to the bus stop. At another time of the year, we would have easily found someone to help me. But now, most of the villages were busy in the fields. Nobody had time to spare for me. In fact, carrying the trunk should not have been such a worry for me, except that my education had made me shun physical labor. After all, I was a government officer, and the idea of people seeing me carry my own luggage was not at all amusing. Otherwise, for a young man like me, it should not have been an issue to carry a 20 kilo chest on my back. Education shun. So, education is supposed to be a kind of advantage for any of the person. But here, education has become a prevention in doing his own work. This is what nowadays being developed, a false prestige. For example, being educated, if I need to carry my rice bag to my home, I automatically depend on either two-wheeler or four-wheeler or some auto rickshaw or something. If it's not available, what to do? What if I carry my own rice bag on my back, on my shoulder, and reach my home? But most cases, people are not doing like this. This is the same problem he has. Related to this, I have a wonderful experience in my childhood. There was a barber, a graduated barber in my town. He was BA in those days. As he couldn't get any of the employment suitable for his education, he started taking barber profession in his father's shop. And all people admired him. But all people cannot do like that. People are very much worried of, very much feel shy about doing something like this. Okay? So, even washing our own clothes, washing our own socks and shoe, you feel it is a little shameful. You expect your mommy to do this or daddy to do this. Why not we? So long when we feel it is something shameful, automatically our education is not going to help us. Education should make us, you know, we always talk about some great people, Abdul Kalam doing his own course and something. Why don't we? Are we greater than Abdul Kalam and all? Mostly, if we do our jobs, we too become equal to them. Simplicity. So, what does it mean? Simplicity means not feeling any of the unwanted shy. If you do something wrong, feel shy. If you are doing something good, which is not harmful to anybody, we should not feel any of the shy. But here, it is a very common fact with the majority of the youth today, people feel it is shame. Okay? Hardly, I believe, nobody is washing our clothes today. Only either mommy or daddy or housemaid are doing. Why can't we wash? That's what I keep on suggesting all of you. You claim me not having any of the socks, colored socks, something, and say, sir, my mommy didn't wash them. Why should mommy wash? Why can't we wash our socks? So, this is important. Yeah. So finally, he was feeling a little shy about it. As there is no availability of any of the ready water, all people in the village are busy with the farm work, and he was thinking of how to carry the chest. Of course, without hesitation, he was telling, of course, it's not going to be a burden for him, but still, he was a government officer, he is a graduate, and so people might feel something shame about his carrying the luggage. That was his feeling. Finally, my father came up with a solution. Don't worry, I myself will see you off at Dirang. So Dirang is the locality where the bus can stop. From there to about some 10 kilometers, they have to walk for his village. So father found a solution that he would like to carry his chest of a trunk till the bus stop. Father is an old man and a rather is an younger one. Is it right thing that older person carrying the luggage and younger person leisurely walking? But still, or rather, accepted. I protested, how could I allow my old father to carry my trunk? What would people think? What would they say? But I failed to dissuade him. I was decided that father would carry the chest. So, even father was not willing his son carrying this. This is what happening in your home also. Your father, your mother, mostly mothers, don't allow you to do something, a small work. When I teach us a suggestion to engage you in some small course, day-to-day course, they say, no, they don't know, sir, anything, something like that. They are with excessive love with you, excessive love. Anything excessive is dangerous. So, you please try to help your parents. Try to give them a helping hand. By that, you get an experience of working. At the same time, you become self-sufficient. At least nearby shopping. Getting a milk packet, something like that. Okay, but most cases, mothers don't accept because you are the most lovable children for them. Okay. So, finally, the father had decided to carry his 20 kilos of trunk on his back till Dirang. A large crowd gathered at our place the day I was to leave. People had come to wish me luck. It was 10:20 when I left for Dirang in the morning. My father had already left. As I had to do a bit of catching up, I walked fast. 3 kilometers down the road, I caught up with my father. Father said, you are late. Would you like to rest for some time? So, you know, whenever we go to our villages during Pongal, Dasara, and all, we have all the near and dear. The day we turn back to Hyderabad, automatically all our friends, relatives, and all they gather and they give us great send off. This is the same thing happened with our father. So, as he was about to get back to his official job, all people gathered and wished him all the good luck. And meantime, the father already started early carrying the trunk, feeling that it is a little burden and he is supposed to reach the bus stop in time. So, after the farewell to each and everyone near and dear, even our father started to reach Dhiran. On the way, after 3 kilometers, he met his father. So, father was 3 kilometers ahead meantime. In the sense we can understand, he was walking fast. You know, though he was old, he was walking fast. And we feel that the father is strong enough to walk in the hilly terrain. I walked fast, I was tired. You know, there is a principle, law of use. Law of use. When we keep on doing something, automatically it becomes a habit and we don't feel it is something burdensome. When we stop working and restart it after an interval, automatically we feel it is a little troublesome. Imagine we got some fever, completely we are under rest. After the fourth day or fifth day, when we about to walk, even a little walk automatically becomes strainsome. But in general, we keep on running, hopping in the playground. So this is what, as we stop some 3 to 4 days because of some weakness, we automatically feel tiresome. This is not the same thing. As his education shunned the walking, or else as he was not frequently walking in the hilly terrain from his place to Dhiran, he got tired. But father was daily walking so that he could walk without any hesitation. I had to cross 2 hills on the way up to the spot. I quickly sat down on a rock. My father laughed at my plight. Though he was young, he got tired. But father, with a luggage, was still continuing. So our father wanted to take some rest for a while. So this little distance has tired you. Rest for a while. But we have to be in time for the bus. Father was quiet for some time. He thoughtfully looked at the sun for a moment. And then his eyes fell on the can of homemade wine that I was carrying. Wetting his lips with his tongue, he said in a matter-of-fact manner, "I'm thirsty." You know, in almost all the northeastern states of India, families, they prepare their own homemade wine. It is a custom for them. Okay. So, as son was going to workplace, they prepared wine and was sending along with him. Now, the father was also an old man. He was thirsty and he wanted to quench his thirst with the available wine. So he asked for it. I gave him the can of wine. He poured himself a mug and handed me the can. He drank all of it at one go. He then arranged the belt that was attached to the trunk carefully on his forehead. So this was the picture. My father carrying my luggage on his back and me following him with a tiny bag in my hand. We were walking up a narrow hilly road and neither of us uttered a word, as if we were strangers who spoke different languages. I did not know what was going on in his mind. You know, silence can make many miracles. Both of us are walking so silent, not talking to each other, as if both of them are strangers. But in fact, they are very intimate, father and son. But there is a psychological distance in their mind. From time to time, it crossed my mind that it was improper for me to let father carry the luggage. So there is something pinching in his mind. Father was old and he's carrying the luggage and he was leisurely walking. So this was pinching in the mind, but still he couldn't take the luggage and carry it. But my guilt and shame did not allow me to do so, but his education dominated. As he was educated in an officer, he so didn't accept to carry the luggage. This self-consciousness had probably to do with my education, the white-collar job that I had, or quite simply my pride. Somehow, I had the feeling that if I carried the luggage, my father and my people, in fact, the whole world would laugh at me and I would be belittled. So he himself was feeling. It happens sometimes. If we do something, how people mean it, how people talk about it, something. People have so many tasks to do. They have no business to look at what you are doing. But we imagine ourselves, people might not accept it, might not appreciate it, what we do, some mean thing, something like that. It is the same feeling in the mind of our other Tongsi. Okay children, we stop here. Please go through the provided worksheet, of course not related to this, but go accordingly and complete it. Thank you.